Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Lake to Lake Girls. We are your hosts, Amanda and Tiffany.
Hey everyone.
Welcome to this Tuesday, April 23rd. Can you believe it's April 23rd?
Oh my gosh. As I was driving over here, I'm like, I wish we could film this outside because it's like perfect.
We should look into that.
Perfect weather right now. It is, and I think by living in upstate New York, we appreciate it just a teensy bit more
than anyone
when it's
else.
Nice because, you know, we can get like 2 weeks of like no sunshine
no
whatsoever,
sunshine.
Complete cloud cover, and there is not a cloud in the sky right now.
I know,
and it's gorgeous and golden out. And
but you heard the bad news, right?
I'm not sure.
It's supposed to rain tonight, and then tomorrow.
Oh, I did hear that about tomorrow. You go popping my bubble.
Freaking A, gotta ruin everything. Well, it is Tuesday. Next week on Lake to Lake Girls, we are going to be having Beth Lynch visit with us. She's going to be starting a new show in a couple weeks, and we're going to preview that with her.
I'm kind of excited.
I'm super excited.
I'm a little nervous.
Nervous, exactly.
See, I'm like, because I'm really apprehensive about these sort of things.
Ditto.
And I've never had like a reading done before, so it'll be interesting.
I've never been officially read by. I did a tarot card. I think I mentioned that before. I did a tarot card.
Yeah.
But nothing like official, like crazy official or anything.
And
so I'm super excited
live,
about it.
So that should be interesting.
Yeah. No telling what's going to happen.
Yeah. There might be some deep, dark secrets revealed.
My goodness. maybe we shouldn't do this.
Yeah. I don't think so. I don't think she would do that.
I think we're good.
Yeah, I think we're good.
She's, I've met her before. She's an amazing woman. She's very fitness oriented.
Oh,
like
nice.
Us. Like, she's very much into it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm looking forward to seeing her and introducing you guys, and then we'll see what happens.
That'll be fun.
But as everybody knows, the Seneca 7 was over the weekend, right? And on the front page of the website, it says 2013 roadkill report.
My internet's not connecting.
It's not working?
Yeah. Well, I even looked at the wireless button, and it's on.
That's so sad.
I don't know what's going on, so I can't see it. But
the 2013 results have posted, and the first all-male was a Cayuga 7.
They're from Ithaca, right?
Yeah,
I saw
won
somewhere
for like 3 years now.
Yeah, like 3 years running, they've won it.
The first mix was Dunk and Bright. Guessing that may be a, like, Dunkin' Bright. I think, I don't know if it's like a play on words.
Like Duncan Hines.
Or anything.
That's what it made me think of.
Klondike Catchers were the second mix group.
Mm-hmm.
But Klondike makes me think of the ice cream bars.
I know, me too.
That's a pretty much one of the only ice creams I like.
Really? What?
I love going to, like, the stands.
Oh, yeah, the soft serve.
But, you know, at home, like, I'm never really ever into eating ice cream. It's kind of, like, probably
really?
A good thing for me,
actually. That probably is a good thing. I love ice cream. I haven't had it in so long. Oh, my gosh.
Do you remember what Cassie's team
was? I don't off the top of my head. If my internet was working, I could look on Facebook. Well, I take it you didn't end up running.
No. Oh, my gosh. I ran on Sunday. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Backstory. Backtracking here. Friday, I went to the gym, and it was an arms day. Arms in my back. And I don't know what I did. I pulled, strained something right here in my rotator cuff of my shoulder.
Oh.
And I could barely lift it. I couldn't go like this.
That's not good. Yeah.
I could do this, and I did this exercise, the pull-ups. But I couldn't lift like this. I couldn't go to the side. I couldn't do a lot of motion. Mm-hmm. So I did my cardio, my abs, and my back, and I left. So real quick workout, not something I'm really used to.
Mm-hmm.
But I got that done. And Saturday, I just said, you know what? Screw it. I'm taking the day off. I am not going to hurt myself. Yeah. I don't want to hurt. Like, I want to be able to continue to work out. So I'm going to take it easy.
Mm-hmm.
And then I, Sunday, I went for a run.
Okay.
And literally, in the first mile,
mm-hmm.
I was like,
it's like, give me my inhaler.
Because it was like the air was so cold and crisp.
It hit
your lungs like a ton of bricks.
Oh, I know what you mean.
Awful. Oh. I was like, thank God. I am not at the Seneca 7.
So congrats to everyone who actually, like, who did it. Because that is such an amazing feat.
Incredible feat.
Yeah.
77.77 miles for That's seven people.
Crazy.
It's like 10, really 11 cool. miles, it turns out to be, for each person.
Yeah, per person.
Three something a leg for each leg. Three something.
I think
between
so, yeah.
Three and four for each leg.
Yeah.
Insane.
Yeah.
I had looked at it, I'm like, meh.
Nope.
I was like, she asked me, I think it was Monday last week, because I told you on Tuesday, and I've just been panicked all week. I'm like,
oh,
I hope those leg heals. I hope
like,
those leg heals.
What did I get myself into?
Because that is a long way to go. And I just, I looked at the map of it. It had to be Thursday. Because I was getting curious at what the legs were. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know what one she was going to have me do if I was going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
And everywhere I looked, I'm like, no.
Yeah, because, like, the shorter, like, the leg is, like, the run, the steeper it is. Like, the more hills and stuff. So, yeah. There's no easy out.
A miserable experience.
Yeah.
If, like, had I been training for that particular event, it probably wouldn't have been so bad. But I've only been doing, like, weight training and running 2 months, maybe.
But to see, that's a lot to, like, throw yourself into also.
Right away.
Yeah. How's your rotator or, like, your shoulder feeling?
After resting it on Saturday, not lifting anything, but going for a run on Sunday. And then yesterday I did legs and stuff. Today I did arms. It feels good. A little tender, but it's good.
Yeah.
It's not like
It's
not like I feared. It's not a horrible, just bad kind of injury. And I got really lucky in that.
Yeah, you just might want to be. My mom tore her rotator cuff 4 years ago, something like that, and she had to have surgery on it.
What?
Yeah, she was out of commission for a long time. It has a really long, like, recovery time.
Oh.
Yeah. Well, I'm not to, like, scare you.
I'm going to be going to the doctor. Amanda says that I need surgery. No MRI needed. Just cut me open.
Yeah.
No. I don't need surgery. No, I don't want surgery. Well, speaking along the lines of fitness, we have your fitness tip for the week. I have a few tips. I don't know if you have a few to chime in as well, but you could probably add on to what I.
Yeah, I'll add on to what
well.
You say.
Something I've noticed is when I started eating better, and it goes along with planning your meals and planning everything like that. Always have water available to you, and this is my reason why.
We're
very much into this. Mine has a little thing.
Do you drink a ton of water?
Mm-hmm.
Me too. I get very thirsty.
Yeah, so
I always have water with me.
Always have this going. Especially in the car or when you're going to a store or something, because that is the biggest place that you're going to mess up.
Oh, that makes sense.
In terms of soda and stuff.
Yeah.
Because that soda is just right there at the checkout counter, readily available. It's only $1 something.
Yep.
I used to be addicted to
impulse,
Pepsi.
Yeah, like impulse buys. They put it there for a reason.
They do. They really do. And it's super hard to stop doing it. And I still have a can every now and then.
Mm-hmm. But to say once in a while isn't going to kill you.
Yeah, but not as bad. And then I get, like, indigestion from it. I start burping because
That's so funny because I had
miserable.
I had a soda. I've like basically completely given up soda.
Mm-hmm. Ditto. That's
I did have a can a couple weeks ago, and it was so like the carbonation was so much. I was like, oh my God. I'm like, how? Yeah, it produced some very unladylike burps. Put it that way. You know, completely off topic, I can burp on command.
Can you really?
Yeah, I can. Do it. It's not like a big one, but like you can I can burp on command. When I was younger, my cousin could do it, and I was like jealous because I wanted to do it too, so I would practice. And now that is one of my very many hidden talents.
Nice.
Burp on command. Yeah.
I would ask if you can do the other thing on command. We won't go there.
Yeah.
We'll stay where we're at.
To get back on track.
In this area. But yes, like in your car, whether it be a bottle of water, go to Walmart, get a $2 one of these doohickeys.
Mm-hmm.
They're really, it's super beneficial, especially with the summer coming. You don't want to be dehydrated. Yeah. Your muscles need to stay
hydrated.
Yeah. I was trying to come up with a different word, but I mean, it's the only thing you can really say. It's from dehydrated to hydrated. It's kind of redundant, but whatever. I thought about it, and it was going along with your ideas of planning and your meals and making sure everything is lined up. And it's super inexpensive. It's water. It's free.
It's practically free. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I've read, too, that sometimes when you think you're hungry, you're actually thirsty.
Really?
Have you ever heard that?
No.
Yeah. Sometimes when you think you're hungry, like, you're actually thirsty.
I think that's why my appetite has changed so much.
Yeah. So, like, drink a glass of water, wait 10 minutes or 15 minutes, and if you're still really hungry,
you're going to have
something.
To satisfy that.
Yeah. But, wait for it to go away.
Wow, that's really cool. I never even thought about that.
Yeah. It's like a sign of a sign of dehydration, but that you're getting thirsty.
Yeah.
Or that your body needs water.
Hallucinations are too, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I believe.
You're really thirsty then.
Well, actually, I've heard that thirst means you already are dehydrated. That when when you feel thirsty, your body, you're actually already, not like severely where you need
but
to
But you need to start hydrating a little
Yeah,
more.
You need to, it means your body, it's your body's natural response of saying, give me water, like,
I
now.
Believe, I buy that. I yeah. think that sounds, makes, that actually sounds right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so my next tip.
Mm-hmm.
I see this a lot, and I'm seeing this a lot lately, especially going to the gym. Don't not do cardio.
Mm, yeah.
Even if you hate it.
Yeah.
Any amount of cardio is good cardio. Whether it be an aerobic exercise with weights. Because there's a lot of weight junkies out there that don't do any kind of cardio, and there's a lot of cardio people that don't do any kind of weight. I think there has to be an even blend.
That's so true. You have to get that balance to it. You need both, because you need strength training to build that muscle, to, you know, up your metabolic rate, but you also need that cardio to keep
burn
your heart
fat,
healthy
burn
and
calories.
Burn fat.
I mean, yeah. it's overall good. I was running a lot. Almost every day before I started going to the gym.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started going to the gym and I started going doing the elliptical. The thing with the elliptical is it's better on my knees.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to do it longer to get the same amount of effect as running.
Mm-hmm.
Which I don't mind. I just amp up the words not coming to the mouth. The resistance.
Yeah.
The resistance.
Like,
Great job, Tiff. We're doing good.
Yeah.
The resistance to it, and I turn it about 12, 13, and I do it for about 30 minutes. So you have 30 minutes of cardio on the... now I can't think... Elliptical.
The gears are turning, but nothing's
happening. Oh, would you see the smoke coming out of my ears? Oh, my word. But... That would be, I can't push enough. The amount of cardio is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
It's something that needs to be a part of your routine. Whether it be going out walking, walking to the gym if you're in walking distance, because that's cardio in and of itself.
Mm-hmm.
Jogging, elliptical. There's this.
What's the recommended amount per week? Is it like 2 hours?
I do way more than that.
Can you look it up?
I'm
not, because I feel like I want to say the recommended amount of cardio for, like, the average person is 2 hours, but I could be making that up. I'm not sure.
Recommended amount of cardio.
I'm trying to restart my laptop to see if it'll...
Turn back on?
Yeah, if I can get back on the internet. I don't know what's going on with it.
Okay. So WebMD, it's like the almighty.
Mm-hmm.
Um... says...
It's a secret.
It is a secret. Apparently it's a secret. Dang, they have it hidden in here somewhere.
We can come back. It was pure curiosity.
To improve cardio and vascular endurance, they recommend 20 to 60 minutes on 3 to 5 days per week. 20 to 60, 3 to 5 days a week.
Okay, so that works out to be like an hour and a half, 2 hours, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it wasn't coming out of left field, I guess.
You weren't wrong, no.
Yeah.
It says, but it could be walking, jogging, mm-hmm. running. Because
what it means basically is your heart rate gets into a certain level, like a certain beats per minute.
Yeah.
So you want to get past,
you want to get
what into is it, the aerobic? Yeah.
You want to get into the aerobic, you have...
Saying all these fancy words like I know what I'm talking about.
But you're right.
Yeah.
You have the base, then you have your weight loss, and then you have the aerobic.
Aerobic, yeah. Do you have any other tips?
Well,
I thought of one.
I know you have a video that you're super excited about.
Yeah, if you want to switch gears.
Oh, yeah. Do you have a tip? Did you say you had a tip?
Yeah.
Go ahead with your tip.
I have one. Well, this is so much easier said than done, though. Working out in the morning before work or, you know, before whatever, like school or whatever your responsibilities are for the day.
Mm-hmm.
Last summer, I was working out 5 days a week in the morning, and I am not a morning person. It was hard. And really, the only reason why I was getting up is because my boyfriend was coming over to my house at 7 in the morning. And I mean, it was good because it kept me accountable. Excuse me. But let me tell you, as hard as it was amazing because you got it out of the way. Like, you know.
That's how I feel.
You don't have that excuse of coming home and being like, oh, I'm so tired, or, like, you work late, or, you know, you have plans in the afternoon. It's done. It's out of the way. You don't have to, like, feel guilty. And it has, like, it sets your day up right.
Mm-hmm.
It has, like, all these, like, positive effects. It's like, you know, no matter what happens today at work.
Good endorphins.
I ran, you know, 2.5 miles or whatever. You know, I walked the dog for an hour or whatever. And you feel like you accomplished something.
I do that. Obviously, I can't. My gym doesn't open until 5. And I have to be at work at 5.
Yeah.
That doesn't work out. But part of my, I've been working these 12-hour days, and it looks like it's going to be happening a lot longer. And a part of the reason why I'm able to be so strong with it is because mm-hmm. I think I'm healthy. Mm-hmm. I'm not bogged down by bad foods. Yeah. And
and it's such a good stress eliminator.
By working out in the
morning. Oh, my gosh.
I go right after I get off the air, my air shift. Then I go work out, shower, go back to work.
It is. If you guys, like, I cannot stress this enough. If you are stressed out or you're feeling depressed or... Go exercise. Go for a walk for a half hour.
Take your dog for a walk.
Yeah, you will feel so much better. Oh, yeah, and back on the internet. That worked.
Woo!
Yay!
Let me tell you about just a little sidetracking here. I tried to call my phone. For some reason, it just did not want to work anymore. It wouldn't let me dial. It kept on saying, oh, your phone calls aren't working. Turn off. And it just exits out of it. I'm like,
what?
What? What are you doing? Then it tells me that my Google Voice isn't working, and it tells me this isn't working. Mm-hmm. I'm like, I'm not dialed in.
I'm You're going through withdrawals. Yeah.
But I was trying to make an important phone call to an attorney of mine, and it wasn't working. I was getting so stressed out.
Uh-huh.
But I guarantee you, a huge stress reliever would be just to throw this thing at the wall.
You get a little aggression out, yeah.
Cause
I hear ya.
Technology seems to be a huge...
When it doesn't work well...
Yeah.
Ugh.
I know in the radio station, all hell breaks loose.
Yeah.
If technology is not working in our favor...
Mm-hmm.
Everything is based around technology in my business right now.
There's no getting it. Yeah, exactly.
So if you're down, you're SOL. So yeah. That would create a lot less stress for me, I'm just saying. But tell me a little bit about this video that you said that came out today.
It was either today or yesterday. It was very recent, within the past week for sure. So I'm sure you guys have heard of Jimmy Kimmel Live. Mm-hmm. He does these videos where it's so funny. But anyways, it's called Lie Witness News. Not Live Witness, but Lie Witness News.
L-I-E.
Yeah. And there's a music festival that's held every year in Coachella Valley, which is it's in Southern California. And the name of it's called Coachella, but it has a longer name. Mm-hmm. And a lot of, known bands, a lot of indie bands play there. It's very, artsy, and, it draws a huge crowd. It's 2 weekends long. A lot of young people go. And, it's very, has this, hippie sort of, feel to it.
Yeah.
And I believe they'll say in the video that there's 60 bands that play.
Wow.
Throughout the 2 weekends. And, they have some huge headliners, but they also have these, smaller, slightly more obscure bands mm-hmm. that might not have a huge following. And, some bands can have some pretty out there names. You wonder, where did they come up with this? So this video, Jimmy Kimmel, one of his, not Jimmy Kimmel himself, but they have someone there mm-hmm. asking people about fake bands. And these people are it is hilarious.
Okay.
They play along and
so right, what you're willing to do to get on TV.
Exactly.
All right. Let's see. Let's take a look at Jimmy's intro first.
One more thing, the Coachella Valley Music and Arts Festival wrapped up yesterday. It's a huge concert, goes over 2 weekends. It's out in the middle of the California desert. More than 60 bands played at Coachella this year. Some of them big bands, some of them not so big, some up-and-coming bands. And music fans in general love knowing about bands that no one else has ever heard of. So we decided to conduct an experiment. We sent a camera crew to Coachella, and we asked people walking into the venue
looks like it's gonna
what
get bad.
They thought of a bunch of bands whose names we made up. Okay? These bands are so obscure that they do not exist. Except for one name you'll hear here. We made all of them up, but that didn't stop people from saying they knew them in tonight's special Coachella edition of Lie Witness News.
I bet you somewhere in the world that one of those bands exist.
Probably.
There's a name for everything.
Have you ever done that where someone's talking? I know when I was younger, probably high school. I've been guilty of it too. Where,
oh yeah, I know that.
Yeah, they're awesome, and
they'll be like, really?
Yeah. Now I'm I have no idea what you're talking about.
We're not afraid. We're not afraid anymore. I'm also guilty of doing this. Someone telling me about this band, oh, they're so good. I'm like, oh, yeah, I know them. Yeah, they're great. And then run home and listen to the
yeah. And you're Googling it on the side of your phone.
I got to memorize this. I got to know who this is. Yeah. Oh, apparently this is an important person that I missed out on. Oh, good Lord. Okay. All right. Let's go back. Lie Witness News. Jimmy Kimmel. Oh, people knowing fake bands. This is super fun. Dun, dun, dun.
One of my favorite bands this year is Dr. Shlomo and the GI Clinic.
Yeah.
The names are so funny.
Yeah, they're always amazing.
Yeah, he's really good on the flexing.
Yeah, I'm really excited to see them live. I think that's going to be one of the bands that's going to be a really great
definitely
live.
Highlight.
Yeah.
Did
yeah.
you see what them the when heck? They played at Lollapalooza?
No, I didn't.
Are you so mad?
I'm so mad.
Have you heard of Shorty Jizzle and the Plumber Crush?
This girl goes right into it. I love
them.
That.
Like how raw they are.
Yeah, they're really unique, for sure.
They feel a little bit like a combination between,
All right, pause, time out for a second. Not only is there this guy right here, this little gem right here, who is...
Hang on, there he is, okay. Oh, yeah, on the phone.
The guy who's riding his bike through the shop, but then says, Hey, I could be a part of TV, and just
there's
stops.
A camera.
And then, oh, I'm cool. I got my camera. I got my
He's
phone.
Like, hey, mom.
I'm talking. Guess what? I'm on TV right now. Just saying. He's just. I don't even know.
Bob Dylan.
And he's going to hang around there for a while. You look at him.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And he's going to pace back and forth.
Are you guys as excited as I am about the obesity epidemic?
I just like their whole style. The obesity epidemic. Their whole genre is just great. They're kind of like innovative and they're new.
There's some smaller bands that are playing. Yeah. Two Door Cinema Club.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to
that. I bet
that.
She's making it up on the spot.
Do you like her,
she is. You can tell her
hesitant.
Yeah, actually, I had a radio show on a community radio station up in Canada, and I used to spend...
He's full of crap right now.
Oh, so full of it.
Oh, community radio.
Yeah, up in Canada. Yeah, I used to spit them all the time.
Them all the time.
Oh, wow. Sounds like a great show. Yeah. One of my favorite bands this year is called Get the F*** Out of My Pool.
Yeah, actually. I've heard from my friends. I don't know any of their music, but I've heard from my friends that it's not something to miss, so I'm not going to miss it.
One of my favorite things today, straight out of Williamsburg, the Chelsea Clintons.
Oh, yeah, I have heard of them, actually. No, yeah, I the don't Chelsea know if it's Clintons, or not, really? But
I feel like that's actually a good name for a band.
What did you hear about?
For a very political band, yeah. Maybe.
They're just fun.
What's fun about the Chelsea Clintons?
I think they just give up.
She looks
energy.
Like she's getting stressed
yeah.
out.
You know what I mean? Yeah, she does look like they're it. Doing it from a good place, and it's like it's and you can just feel energy. I feel and like there's very few acts that like give you that feeling.
I feel like that feeling, but they feel. Did you know that, Amanda? She feels.
She feels them.
Did you know that Coachella is actually the American Indian word for dumb white guy?
Look at this guy.
Coachella 2013.
We love Coachella.
Are you guys excited for Regis and the Philbin?
Very excited.
Regis and the Philbin.
Oh my gosh.
Heaven.
When I watched that earlier, I wasn't sure. Okay. The first thought was, this is hilarious. The second thought is,
how dumb can you be?
Like,
it's people, not you.
I don't know how this reflects on, like, young Americans.
This is the future of America.
Yeah. I fear a little bit. I mean, it's so funny, though. But like we said earlier, we've been guilty of it.
Yeah, we have.
I mean, because you don't...
But this is for TV, though. You don't...
Yeah. Like, you... I guess, like, if you're at this huge, like, well-known music festival, you don't want to be like, I don't know who they are.
I guess there's a positive. You could spit it positively, mm-hmm. though. Like, be like, oh, I've never heard them, but I'm real yeah. excited. Maybe I'll, you know,
and so
like
that,
a new
that
band
one girl who's like, yeah, my friends tell me they're like, I can't miss them. They're amazing.
They're like fun, and I get this feeling that I feel like really mm-hmm. feeling. It's good. It's
mm-hmm. good stuff. Jimmy Kimmel. Yeah. He has really funny videos.
He does.
I suggest you guys check his YouTube video or channel out.
Ditto. I agree. Okay. I can't.
You know what dubstep is, right?
No.
I know I am getting old because I can't stand it.
What is dubstep?
It's like...
I'm getting old. I don't even know what it is.
I feel like it's a type of genre of music that, I don't know if it came out a couple years ago, but it definitely was popularized just a couple years ago. It's sort of like techno music, but screeching is the best way for me to put it.
There's dubstep dance, okay?
You have to be like, to enjoy it, you need to be in an altered state. Like, I don't understand. It hurts my head. I cannot stand it. I mean, you know, it's great. If someone loves it, awesome, no judgment. But I feel like I'm getting old because I know I can't listen to it.
The video says, please do not adjust the volume. So, the screeching, I'm guessing. Do you want to hear? Do you want to see this thing?
Yeah.
All right. We'll show just a snippet. Oh, good Lord. I'm very scared about this. It's the dubstep dance is what it's called.
Oh. I've never seen this, but why are they outside like a convenience store?
I don't know, but there's beer there.
What is happening?
Oh, hold on. Oh, nuts. I didn't have the volume on. Something's happening inside me.
All right, we'll see if it does it yet. It's usually during the chorus.
Am I going to want to cry?
No. It's like dance club music.
So just see the beat.
I don't hear it yet though. So maybe now. I'm waiting for it.
Me too. This is going to be a huge letdown, isn't it? Dancing is pretty cool, though. If you look at his
dancing,
dance.
I mean, is that dubstep dance, though? That just
looks
like...
That's what it says. It's dubstep dance.
I don't know.
It kind of like reminds
me
of the robot.
I don't understand it.
Oh,
not the dancing,
word.
But the music. That's actually a little less
fun for me.
Obnoxious than I've heard other songs.
Still wasn't fun for me.
No, it's...
I guess I'm not a clubber anymore.
No, me either.
It's really sad. Actually, about it.
I can't stand when you go to a bar or something and you can't talk to the people you're with because
the
music's so loud.
Too loud.
Not a fan of that.
Oh, good lord.
Reason We're number two old. For tonight why I'm getting old.
I was told my age was showing today when I didn't know of a band or some artist from like the 30s or
Who
the
told
40s.
You that?
My boss.
oh, okay,
but
I got it.
It's in the fact that I'm too young, but yeah. I think
the 30s
I feel like
I'm
old.
It's like your grandparents. Like why would they expect you to know that?
I mean, I know who Anne Murray is.
Mm.
Yeah, you don't know who that is.
I don't know who that is.
She sings this song, Can I Have This Dance for the Rest of Our Lives? It's the song that my grandma and grandpa danced to on their wedding day.
Oh, that's so cute.
Yeah, I Aww. Decided... Whoever I'm going to marry, if I ever get married, not looking good right now.
Oh, no.
that would be the song that I'm going to dance to.
That is so freaking cute. I love it.
but that's besides the point. we have about 20 minutes left of the show.
Mm-hmm.
And...
Oh, nice. We have a DIY.
Do it yourself. For the first time, though. This is my first time doing this.
All right.
And I have with me a pair of jeans
mm-hmm.
from American Eagle. But with summer coming,
mm-hmm.
and these pants, I don't know if you can see it, but they've got a yellow marker or yellow paint stain on them. All over them. You see it right there-ish?
Kind
area.
Of.
I brought them, and I figure we can show a way to do it yourself, cut your own shorts
mm-hmm.
for the summer.
Jorts, yay!
Jorts! And it's for your budget, and because I ruin these, and I don't want to get rid of them because mm-hmm. they're one of my favorite pairs, but I ruined them. And it made me really sad, so I said, Amanda,
we're
going to
give them a new life today.
We're going to try.
You're going to try. No, we may actually kill them.
They may die. I'm actually hoping not to be able to wear them soon.
I know, me too. It would be nice. May is just around the corner.
It is.
Yay!
Speaking of which, I might not get to wear these anytime soon.
Is it
Lake to Lake Girl Challenge?
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
Are you super excited?
I'm
okay.
excited for it.
We said this in last week's show, and we're just mm-hmm. going to remind our listeners and viewers. What's happening is Amanda and I have this challenge going. She has an original challenge with her boyfriend, Jared.
Mm-hmm.
And the goal for that is for Amanda to beat Jared.
What it is, we each have our own fitness goal that we're trying to reach, and the winner, if there's a winner and a loser, the winner has to pay for skydiving for the both of us, which is really expensive for two people especially. But we decide if we both reach our goal, if we both win, in essence, we're just gonna pay for ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not paying. Put it that way. I had a really good weigh-in we did it on Saturday last week, so I'm still on track.
Yay!
Plus 10.5 pounds. Yeah, it was nine
Holy.
Last time, so yeah, 10.5.
Nice.
So hopefully it stayed off, but.
Over the weekend. you know what I've noticed now that I've been working out? I don't know if you've noticed this, but especially with the springtime and everything, I feel like I'm wearing brighter clothes.
Mm-hmm.
Brighter clothes are not as forgiving as dark.
No, that's true.
And tighter.
And they're more, they're more attention getting.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I haven't gotten my spring clothes out yet, so.
I'm really super excited because I'm feeling more confident. Spring clothes, what do you mean you haven't gotten them out yet? You store them away?
Yeah.
I incorporate my spring with winter, and my winter with my spring and the fall and the summer. It all, it's a way I save money, though.
Yeah. Well, I have clothes that I wear year-round, but I definitely have, I couldn't fit all my clothes. I have a tiny, tiny closet. I couldn't fit everything in there. But things like sandals and some heels and a lot of, summer dresses and tank tops I store away. Yeah.
I get you. That makes sense.
And I haven't gotten those out yet.
How far down from the crotch do you think I should start?
If you're just joining us, Tiffany is in the process of creating jorts. Jean shorts.
But like we were talking about, we are created our own fitness challenge.
Mm-hmm.
So Amanda will take her challenge beyond that and not give up and go for more.
Yeah, we're going to make it till Labor Day, right?
Till Labor Day.
Yeah.
We have each a pair of jeans that we want to be able to fit into and look snazzy.
Mm-hmm.
And those are our goals. We don't really, right now it's just a fun kind of thing.
Yeah, we want to get prizes and we want to get you guys involved. We want to know
involved.
Yeah, we want to know what your goal piece of clothing is and I want to give some people some cool prizes.
We want to help you into those clothes.
We're going to do this together.
Yes. It would be cool to have. I mean, I think it's inspiring to see other people be successful. So,
mm-hmm.
I mean, we can inspire you. You can inspire us to do more. I know one of our friends, Cassie, she's just one of the biggest inspirations in terms of getting in shape and fitness that I have ever run into in my entire life.
Mm-hmm.
She can run freaking 77.77 miles with 6 other people.
It takes a lot of hard work, for sure.
It takes a lot of determination to do something like that. Me and Amanda are going to be in the Finger Lakes Mun Run as well.
We are. I'm excited. That's not to the fall, but
and
it's going to be fun.
And you got Jared
into
it, too.
I did.
I'm so excited.
We're all going to be on the team. How many people are going to be on the team?
I think it's 5.
5? Okay.
So we got 3 other people that we would have to fill space for. So we could fill that with a Lake to Lake Girl viewer as well if we wanted to.
Yeah. Wait, no. Wouldn't it only be 2 more people? It's 5.
Oh, yeah. I'm just kidding. But we want to get you guys involved, so let us know what your fitness goals are. Let us know what your fitness goal outfit is. Post it on our Facebook, Lake to Lake Girls. Mm-hmm. You can even go to my Twitter page. It's TiffCollins8.
And we'll get more, official, rules and stuff out. And, we should get sponsors. We'll get it more finalized for you guys. But we just want to let you know we're putting it out there.
Yes. I think it's a great idea to get people just a part of it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's great to be a part of something like that because, I mean, they have, AA meetings for a reason because you are stronger in numbers kind of thing. Like, you have reinforcement.
You have that positive support group atmosphere.
Yeah.
And that's what we are creating for you guys.
And we also, I kind of want to bring in viewers into the show.
I think that would be so fun.
On the show. I think you guys should come in on the show. Let us know what your goals are, whether or not you just when you're starting out or you have a story to tell, like a before and after. We want to be a part of it. We want to do a lot more with fitness because it's just it's a growing phenomenon. People getting into shape and
it's so important.
It is.
Half of our country is obese. You know, it's a huge topic and we're all in it together and it's a daily commitment. It really is to getting healthy.
Did you know that there is a doctor that is declining obese people?
I've heard about this. I think I heard about it on the news.
Yes, I did too. She declined to operate or something on a 200-pound woman because she was considered obese. And
interesting.
I kind of see both sides.
Yeah.
Quite honestly, I don't disagree with what her reasoning's behind it. I can't remember her name, I apologize, but she discussed that with people who are obese or bigger, it takes longer to conduct regular exams because apparently when you're bigger and you have, an abnormal polyp or some kind of cancerous nodule or something, it's easier to find it on someone who is not, and when you're bigger, you take a lot longer time to go through, and it's mm-hmm. a lot more time consuming.
Mm-hmm.
And
you makes sense.
And there's a lot of room for missing something.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can get a lawsuit against you for
negligence
and it's along the line of negligence, and doctor's offices can't really afford that kind of thing.
So it's too much of a liability, almost sounds like. Liability.
They say it's a liability not only to for that reason, but like your chances of something going wrong are mm-hmm. greater. And apparently it's legal. Did you know it's legal to do that?
It almost seems like it's a form of discrimination.
That's what the big question is.
It's also a lifestyle choice.
That's what the big question is, that it's discrimination.
Yeah.
But what she does is she recommends them to another facility that mm-hmm. handles strictly abused people. And her thought on the topic was that if she recommends them to an obese clinic,
mm-hmm.
they're going to recognize that their weight is a problem.
Mm-hmm.
If they didn't already know.
And then maybe they'll do something about it. I would just say every overweight person knows they're overweight. It's whether you're like, whether you want to face it or not.
True.
Every woman knows when she's gained weight. Or, you know, it's just like, you know, it's like, you don't need to tell me, we know it. But at the same time, sometimes you do need that wake-up call. Sometimes hearing the harsh truth from your doctor is the kick in the butt that you need to, you know, get healthier for yourself and your family and your, you know, your future and all that stuff. Oh, have we started the Jorts?
I'm trying.
I just see you, like, ripping the fabric over there.
It's hard.
Why aren't you cutting it?
Because I want the riffles.
No, it'll cut. Just cut it and, like, wash it. It'll come.
When you cut it, it'll come.
Yeah.
What is that? If you build it, they will come?
Something like that.
Oh, heavens. Here it goes.
So how long did you... Let me see this. How... You just went right for it. That's pretty good.
It's not bad, right?
You could, like, roll it up once or twice.
I think so. Yeah. I didn't want to cut it, but that's where, like, the... down right there is where, like, the highest stain of that yellow was. So, I mean, I might have to give them to my little sister, Amanda, depending on where they lie on my legs. But, I mean, not bad. We'll see how they... I'll let you know how it goes.
All right.
I'll put them on when I get home and then put a picture up on our Facebook.
Let me know. I know shorts can be... Cutting shorts can be really hard to judge if you've never done it before.
I'm just going for it.
Yeah, just go for it. I find, just a tip for everyone out there, if you're not sure, cut it a little on the longer side.
That's
and, like,
I...
try to roll it up a couple times because you can always cut a little more off. You know, it looks uneven.
A little bit. No big deal.
Nice. Well, you know, honestly.
This is an epic failure.
Honestly, like, some people, like, stores charge a lot of money for, like, shorts like that that have literally been, like, cut off and, like, rolled up. You know what I mean?
Extra money. It's ridiculous.
And, like, distressed stuff. I'm like, I'm not going to pay that, you know,
like, sorry, that much honey, money. I really don't want to pay that.
Yeah. That looks better.
Better?
That looks good.
Hold on. Okay. I think. We'll see.
Okay.
We'll see. That's not bad. It looks like a midway down my calf, I'm hoping. If it's not midway down my calf, it's not bad.
Midway down your calf.
Midway.
You don't even mean your thigh? I know.
Maybe.
I'm like, did you mean to cut capris? Because.
Yeah, these are my capris. You just wait till what my shorts are.
Oh, man. That's funny.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it's one of those nights.
It is. These are my favorite pants. I hope I did not ruin them.
Really, I'm sure you can salvage them somehow.
I will. Find a way.
At the very least, you could use them as, like, a bathing suit cover-up. You know what I mean?
Ooh, that's not a bad idea.
If they're, like, cockeyed or whatever, just wear them to the beach.
Yeah. All right. So, Jorts, that's a good way to save money.
Mm-hmm.
That's somewhat. Yeah, we'll go with that.
Yeah.
We'll go with that. We'll take this as a success. For now. Wait till I go home and try mine. And then we'll see what's going on. All right, so it is 6:46. We have about 4 minutes left to the show. Just some closing statements, you guys. Just a recap. Literally, water bottle. Carry it with you. And whether it be this or the disposable stuff, those are pretty big, hot topics.
Yeah, disposable because isn't it, like, bad for the earth and stuff to use disposables? Because a lot of them end up in landfills.
I don't know what's good, what's bad anymore. Everything is
and
just...
if you get a water bottle, you should get BPA-free, you know. And it'll say labeled on the water bottle if it is BPA. Yeah, it'll specify it. Because I remember there was a time period a couple years ago. I was going through, like, so many water bottles because, you know, Victoria's Secret Pink, that line? They have the cutest water bottles.
Really?
So freaking cute. It, like, very girly, and they're big, and they have, like, the nipple top, for the lack of a better word. You know, like, the... Nipple. Yeah. Now, so, and, like, I prefer that in a water bottle because it doesn't, like, spill all over you. And then I find out they're not BPA-free. I'm like, great, it's going to give me cancer, so I can't use this. So I recycled that one. And then I bought an aluminum one. Have you ever had an aluminum water bottle? They have a funky taste to them.
I did not
like it. And so I'm like, great, now I need to, you know, get another one. And then I finally got this one.
The water bottle people made a lot of money off of it.
They did. They suckered me into it. And I've had this one for a good long while, so
I've had this one for a couple months.
Yeah,
it depends on how long it takes me to get bored with it, but it's one of my favorite colors, so it should be good. I mean, I'm relatively
I like this one because
mine has a nipple top, like you said.
No, it doesn't actually. Mine does. It's like a pour top or whatever. It doesn't like pop out, but this is like leak proof. Yeah, it is never. It is leaked, so I really like it. And it also has this cool little, like, tracker thing on the side where you can, like, keep track of how many, bottles you've drank.
Ditto.
So.
Mine has that.
This is a very good advertisement for Thermos water bottles.
We should be. We're a walking, talking advertisement, I know. For Pete's sake. All right, well, thank you for joining us to another episode of Lake to Lake Girls. We are your hosts, Amanda and Tiffany. Next week, we're going to be joining alongside us Beth Lynch.
It's going to be a very interesting show, I think.
Eye-opening.
Yeah.
Eye-opening. Yes, I like that. So be sure to join us and tune in. We'll see what we have. You can see what we have in store. Join us on Facebook at Lake to Lake Girls, also on Twitter, TiffCollins8. If you would like to, we have all of our updates. We post random fun things.
We do.
Amanda, you're a lot more diligent about that than I am.
Well, yeah, I go through cycles of it where I'm like, yeah, let's post this and this and this. And then I like, won't do it for 2 weeks. Trying to be more consistent.
You gotta be diligent. We got this. Okay. All right, you guys. But thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you again this time next week, 6 to 7, Tuesday night, Lake to Lake Girls. You guys enjoy your night.
Enjoy the beautiful weather.
Bye, guys. Such good weather.
So excited.